So when metal is electron-rich species, so metal will shift its electron density toward carbon, and definitely the electron density or charge on carbon will move in reverse direction or will get inward, and in case of this inversion, then nucleophilicity of carbon will change or will convert into electrophilicity. So we have to take on board the other ligands attached to metal center, not only carbonyl, and then we can decide on the basis of that fragment that what type of reactions we are going to experience in a particular species. Now, if back donation is encouraged, so what type of characteristics we will observe in the complex, or in what type of complexes we can observe such type of characteristics? So carbon will lose its partial positive charge, and oxygen will become significantly partial negative or electron rich. So in this case, if back donation is encouraged, back donation encouragement means that metal is electron rich species, and what happens, metal will donate back electron to metal to carbon center, and a double bond will form, and this deformation of a double bond will increase the partial positive characters on the partial positive charge or partial positive character on carbon will decrease, while oxygen will significantly become electron rich. If we compare the electronic environment of both the species in case of a metal where back donation is discouraged, and in case of a metal where back donation is encouraged, so in both the cases we can compare, and this comparative study can lead us toward the reactivity of species, that what type of reactivity we have to carry out, or what type of reactivity a carbon will carbon monoxide will experience. Here three examples are given. In this case, in all the three cases, metals have different nature. For example, this metal is only capable to accept the lone pair from carbon, and this metal is regarded as poor metal, or in other words, we can call it electron deficient. Electron deficient means, although the carbon possess certain orbitals which we call as LOMO or antibonding molecular orbital, and this metal is definitely d block element. So in case of d block elements, d orbital is available, and whenever d orbital and sigma star are antibonding molecular orbital of carbon, they overlap, so they are capable to overlap and they participate in bonding, as we have already discussed in our other lectures. So in case of their involvement, other bond is possible, but the electronic nature of metal and carbon, it does not allow them to make or to establish another bond. Therefore, because metal does not have electron in its d orbital in order to donate them to carbon, therefore this metal is regarded as electron deficient species, or this is poor metal or electron poor metal. We can say we can give any name to the metal. So in this case, what happens, electron density has been shifted from carbon toward metal, and as a result of this shifting, metal possesses now partial negative charge because electron density has been increased on metal, and this electron density flows from carbon towards metal. Therefore, carbon gets electron deficiency, and this is the representation of charges, and resultantly this oxygen gets more electron deficiency, because now electron will shift or will drag its electron, will push its electron in order to fulfill deficiency being created here by this coordinate covalent bond. So we will experience a positive charge on oxygen. So in this case, now this is one, or this is qualitatively the polarity of carbon monoxide, that it is partial positive and this is completely positive, and negative charge has been located on metal. And now if metal is electron rich comparatively, and the d orbital possesses at least a pair of electron, where back bonding is encouraged, So a multiple bond is formed between carbon and oxygen, and as a result of this multiple bond, because electron density shifts from metal to carbon, now what happened? Carbon has established two bonds with metal center, and previously there were three bonds between carbon and oxygen. Now a valency of carbon will become oversaturated, and this oversaturated has to be readjusted. And as a readjustment, what will happen? This pair of electron will again localized on oxygen, or it will move toward oxygen toward its respective orbital from where it was already donated. And now the valency of carbon as well as oxygen is satisfied. So this is actually the electron rich species as compared to this one, the metal one, the metal. And in this case, the polarization is almost neutral is for normal what we can say carbon monoxide we observe. Now in this case, what happens when this pair of electron is localizing on oxygen? So that in other words, we can say negative charge. So this negative charge will cancel this positive charge, and from here the electron density from carbon was shifted toward metal, and this type of charge was created as we have represented here. Now metal will donate electrons back to carbon, and these charges will get reverse or inverse, and the negative and positive will cancel the effect of each other. So this species is comparatively neutral species. So electrophilicity or nucleophilicity of carbon is cannot be observed with greater effect, or we can say visibility cannot be seen in the electron the reactivity of these species, although they will be reactive as compared to free carbon monoxide. On the other hand, if a metal is far electron rich, it has more electrons, and it is capable to establish three bonds between carbon and metal center. Now at least an additional orbital as compared to this species is also available to get overlap between carbon and metal. And as we have discussed that carbon, the LOMO and HOMO both are localized on carbon, not on oxygen. So through carbon center, the carbon monoxide makes bond with metal center. So whenever electron density is shifted toward carbon, now in this case one pair of electrons has been donated by carbon to metal center, while metal donates two pairs of electrons to carbon. So metal gets electron deficient, and resultantly the carbon gets electron rich. This electron density has to be minimized or has to be readjusted, and what happens, this bond also becomes localized on oxygen in order to leave this carbon with satisfied valency, which is 4. So if carbon can make 4 bonds, so now around carbon there are 4 bonds, and rest of electron density is localized on oxygen. Now we have 2 charges, negative and positive, and one negative charge, negative charge is localized on oxygen and positive charge is localized on metal. So in this case, now electron density on metal is too much, on carbon is too much, and this carbon is at least now susceptible or sensitive toward electrophilic attack, not nucleophilic attack. In this case, it was more sensitive toward nucleophilic attack, and in this case it will be sensitive toward electrophilic attack. So this was all about electrophilicity and nucleophilicity, or charge induced reactivity of carbon monoxide. And inshallah, in next lecture we will move further. Thank you very much.